country. Two, to say well done for the journey so far. As I told His Excellency on our one-on-one chat, our CEO remains the number one fan. He tells me how optimistic Ghanaians have become, how your government so far has demonstrated purposefulness. He reminded me or told me about the independence celebration, how it was done in a business-like fashion and contained costs. She tells me, and I know this from interactions I've had with people from outside this country, how investors' confidence is rising. I thought we should bring the good will of our bank to you and to say, sir, that we are very happy about all of this and your promise to the good people of Ghana. We would like to associate with your government. We would like to support your government any way possible, both in banking and in our other engagements. Beyond banking, sir, the card I gave is S Holdings. United Bank of Africa is one of the companies, businesses we have invested in. We also have interest in other areas, from real estate hospitality to oil and gas to power. We are the biggest generators of electricity in Nigeria today. And we operate in other sectors and would like also beyond banking and financial support to see how we can do in the country. In the last dispensation, it's on record that we supported the government of Ghana with almost $1 billion. Then the central bank, we gave them first, I think it was $600 million, then we gave another about $500 million, so about $1.1 billion. We supported when the currency they needed support. We remain the only African bank that operates in the United States of America. We use some of these, especially the New York office, to gather support for serious-minded countries and governments. We would like to support your government. We would like to make investment where opportunities exist. UBA Ghana has done well, and we are happy. Because of the progress UBA Ghana has achieved, we decided to build a head office, defeating head office. We are going to turn this out tomorrow, part of this visit, so that we want to do more. We have about 30 branches in Ghana. We want to do even more in Ghana. We have a great team, a great board here, but with your government, we want to do even a lot more than we've done. So, Your Excellency, this is first a series of visitations that will come from us to you. And I thought we should let you know that you have in us willing and to some extent capable partners who would like to, who are proud and happy to identify the government. I thank you for the warm reception we've gotten.
I feel it's a very special day. All of us very much in admiration of the work you've been doing. Not just concentrating on Nigeria, but looking beyond the borders of Nigeria and taking root in countries like Ghana and elsewhere. I think this is really at the heart of what we want to see on this continent. African entrepreneurs who also have a regional and continental perspective and outlook on the problems that we have. We came here because the economy of our country has taken a nosedive in the last few years, and the people of Ghana felt that there was a need for a new direction and a new leadership in the country. So our first principal, overwhelming task is what we need to do to revive our economy and put our economy back on the road to growth and expansion. It's only by growing our economy that we can solve some of the basic social problems of our nation. This is principally unemployment amongst the youth of our country. We want to grow our agriculture, we want to grow our industry. And we want to have a financial system that will support the growth of these two pivotal sectors. So UBA and the role it plays in our economy and in the wider African economy is the kind of partner that we are looking for to assist us in delivering on our vision and on our mandate. It's a difficult one, but I think that challenges are the nature of life, and perhaps the more difficult it is and the more challenging it is, some of us feel more secure than when things are easy and floating well. So we're looking for UBA to be very proactive in the new arrangements in Ghana. And I'm very, very happy to hear the sentiments that you yourself express, and the young lady who's such a very key member of the Ghana business community. Our main task is how to create that enabling environment that would allow people to invest and put their monies here and to help us grow our economy. That's the main task. We're not, as government, coming to compete with businessmen. That's what's going to happen with members of my government. They're coming to facilitate the doing of business, increase the business confidence in Ghana, and by that way, develop Ghana rapidly. And we think that the private sector, the Ghanaian private sector, the private sector writ large, is the way forward for us. And we're going to do whatever we can. Already the first budget of our government has come, and it has pointed the way to how we intend to handle the private sector. Yeah, the first budget, yes. We've removed the many of the impediments that there is to the doing of business in Ghana. There's a lot more work we have to do, but we've already started signaling to the private sector that whatever we can do from the part of government to enable the private sector to strengthen and grow and develop, that's the way we want to go. Many of the taxes that have burdened the private sector have come, even the ones on financial transactions, have all been removed. Yes.
Since you took over,
we've done it all. We want to signal to the private sector that we mean business when we say we want the private sector to play this catalytic role. So we're counting on UBA to have a good understanding of where we are, what we're doing, and where we're going. And especially to be in the position to fund these critical areas: agricultural development, industrial development. In the African context, both are difficult areas of activity, especially agriculture. It all is difficult. But at the same time, that's where a considerable part of the wealth of our countries are. And if we can find a solution to being able to fund the development of the modernization and development of our agriculture, a great deal of the task of putting our economy on a self-sustaining path of prosperity will have been achieved. So, thank you very much for coming. I want us to be in the position to call upon you and your managing director at all times. We need to have an engagement areas which we think would be interesting for you to look at, and mutually you will benefit. Fortunately, all the people in this government, the key people, we're all private sector people, and we understand the need to make profit as a way that you can increase the competitiveness of businesses. So this is and especially the founder, the chairman of the bank, the work he's been doing, which we all see on television and everywhere we go, is something that is very encouraging. Yes. We believe that entrepreneurship, the creativity, sense of enterprise of us Africans has to be the way forward. And if we can develop that, then we can jump the big hurdle of underdevelopment that is so bogging us down. But I'm optimistic about the future. I think that if people like us can stretch our hands and hold hands together, the possibilities are limitless in what we can do together. to get our countries going. The theme of our government is that we want to build a Ghana beyond aid. We're tired of being beneficiaries of handouts and charity. We want to be able to stand on our own 2 feet and to deal with our issues ourselves. We want that partnership with people like you to be able to do that. So you're welcome. Thank you very much. Thank you very much for coming.
I'm so touched about looking at people from my entourage and all the things you said here, the right things, the role of private sector, the role of entrepreneurship in developing Ghana and the continent, the significant, the critical role of agriculture, very, very important. All I can say, Your Excellency, is on industrialization, I'm aware of the one factory, one local government area. I would have conversation with the CEO and see how immediately we can support your efforts in this area.
Right. That's really great. So, I'm going to hold you.
we'll do so immediately and also see if we have initiatives that can help further boost your revenue collection so that there are more to support your great initiatives. It's wonderful. I come, about 3 years ago, Tony Blair and I created the Blair Elumelu Fellows to support African governments. We supported governments in Liberia, Sierra Leone, Rwanda, and Nigeria, basically to capacitize the ability and capacity for public sector to help support private sector in these economies. And now to see a government or your government thinking in the manner that you're thinking is wonderful. And also, totally agree with you, and it resonates very passionately with me, the issue of Africa is ready for business and not faith. It's wonderful. And truly, that also is the way to sustainable development for our people. And that is how we can indeed become truly self. Political independence is one thing, but economic independence to a larger extent is extremely important, which we lack as a continent. And people like you can provide a new hope, and we will stand by you to make this happen. My foundation, we support 1,000 entrepreneurs every year across Africa. In Ghana, I'm hosting them later today. Since I came, I thought I should spend time with them. I will also visit the Impact Hub Center, Co-Creation Center, to support, to encourage them, because entrepreneurship is the way to go. I'll be addressing about 150 of them when I leave here, and further support them. We have beneficiaries of our foundation work in Ghana already. I think first year we had about 50 people, second year about 30. This year, next week, we are going to announce the winners, and I'm sure a lot more will come. But I'm encouraged listening to you about your commitment and resolve to support entrepreneurs, because creating the right environment for them to do well is much more important than even capital. So if we would like to support more Ghanaian entrepreneurs, because under this kind of government, they will do even better. So well done, Your Excellency. We are willing partners as a bank, as investors, and also as a foundation. Congratulations, sir.
Thank you very much. Thank you.